And there are two types of boundaries, proactive and reactive boundaries. And let's talk a little bit about each type. Reactive boundaries is our emotional reaction to the respective situation. When a child is screaming, crying, throwing food on the floor, throwing toys on the floor, a child is saying, no, I don't want this. I will not do this. A child is protesting, and often he does not say what he wants. Instead, he just shows his protest. And this is normal for a child up to 6-7 years old. This is how children learn how to protect their boundaries, their territory, their toys, their belongings, their interests. And parents' reaction is extremely important during this period. Parents should teach a child that it's not okay to scream, it's not okay to bite other people, it's not okay to be rude, it's not okay to break things, but it is okay to protect your boundaries and speak up about your feelings and emotions. And parents should teach a child how to talk, how to find the solution in a difficult situation, how to negotiate, how to offer a compromise. But parents often miss this second part. They punish a child for screaming, they punish a child for being rude, but they do not teach us how to protect our boundaries, how to protect my toys. So they tell me, my parents told me, like, you have to share with your little brother. Don't be rude. Don't bite. Don't scream. But they don't tell us, how can I protect my toys? How can I go and play outside with other kids and protect my toys? And as a result, a child learns to assume a victim role or becomes a selfish narcissist. The person with a victim type of personality gets upset over small things, creates drama, slams the door, manipulates, lies, cries, creates conflicts, and always blames other for problems. And at the same time, a person that assumed a victim's role, he suffers a lot. He feels that people don't appreciate him, that nobody cares about him, that nobody understands him. And often a person develops psychosomatic syndromes, such as high blood pressure, anxieties, and constant stress. And this is the reason that person gets upset quickly, because that person feels that nobody loves him, nobody listens to him. That's why this person lies, creates drama and conflicts, because he believes that people do not love him and people don't care about him. And the second type that we can get as a result of parents do not teaching us how to create healthy boundaries, we can get a person with a narcissistic personality. A narcissist behaves aggressively. A person who is not a victim, but a person who is an opposite to a victim. A narcissist often abusive, and he can physically hurt others, or he can use abusive words. A narcissist also manipulates, and he does not respect the opinion of others. He believes that he can violate laws and rules and other people's boundaries, but when other people violate his boundaries and break his rules, he becomes cruel, cold, and violent. And reactive boundaries always based on emotion. We react. That's why it's called reactive boundaries. Reaction based on our reaction, on our emotion. When I am mad, I scream. When I feel ashamed, I cry. When people disagree with me, I must prove that I'm wrong. Some narcissists can say that they regret their reactions. But if a person does not know how to manage his anger, it does not mean that you should forgive him or ignore his rude behavior. You should not sacrifice yourself, you should not sacrifice your desires, your dreams, just because another person does not know how to control his anger. And the second type of boundaries is proactive boundaries. And proactive boundaries are when a person chooses his reaction. Everybody has a choice. You should make your choice based on the following factors. Who are you talking to? Is it a family member? Is it your boss? Is it your co-working or your friend? Second, what result do you want to achieve in your situation? Do you want to keep your job, your friendship, your relationship or not? The third is it the first time when a person has been rude to you, or has he done this many times before? Those questions you have to think in your head before you're gonna react. So you have to choose your reaction based on those things. And remember that you always have a choice in any situation with any person. You have a choice. And if you don't know how to do it, you can learn this. I've learned it, now I can teach you, and you can learn this too. And the more we fall back into our old behavior patterns, the more we suffer. You can continue to live in resentment, this is also your choice. You can continue suppressing your inner anger, falling into a victim behavior, remaining silent, swallowing your pain and hoping for a miracle. Or you can change your life. You can change your life by attending one of my online workshops. And you can see the schedule of upcoming events and workshops at my website, which is elenasemenek.com, or you can click the link below this video and see what I prepared for you. Reactive boundaries, when we react, also called childish boundaries. And those boundaries lead to addictive relationships, to pain and to frustration. And life moves forward. Even if you stay on the same level, life's move forward, then you will descend even deeper and deeper and deeper in your personal suffering. And one day it might be too late to create a successful career. It might be too late to have a baby. It might be too late to quit smoking because you already have cancer. And if you have your dreams, if you don't know how to achieve them, then welcome to my self-development online training workshops. I will be happy to teach you. We're gonna heal your inner child. We're gonna heal your inner trauma, your childhood trauma. And you will learn how to create healthy boundaries, how to create healthy relationship. You will work on your self-esteem and you will learn how to create the life that you really want and really deserve.